Uh-oh. Trouble in La La Land? And it's not the Lakers? It's not the Lakers? Look, the Lakers have had their, you know, Kuzma's popped off a little bit, and there's those rumors, but for the most part, they've kept things in-house, and it seems like their chemistry's been pretty good, right? McGee, Howard, the bigs have kind of set the tone, and the veterans. You got to credit Dwight Howard, and then obviously LeBron for, you know, so far so good with their chemistry, but it's the Clippers now that reportedly are having some locker room issues. You've seen little sprinkles of it with Montrezl Harrell, some of the body language, some of the attitude. He had that one press conference, right? But The Athletic reported yesterday that apparently some of the Clippers feel a type of way about Kawhi and Paul George receiving preferential treatment. Okay, fine, right? And you understand, look, in today's NBA, the power moves, we all saw how Toronto was rewarded for handling Kawhi a year ago, right? And so the Clippers have to follow suit. Remember, Kawhi and Paul George are still somewhat holding the Clippers hostage with a 2-in-1 deal, right? They can get out of these contracts here in 2021. And so they're not exactly like signed up for the long haul. And so you understand why the Clippers have to do these type of things and cater to them. And obviously Kawhi's load management, and it's such a gray area. You can't really prove things right or wrong, right? It's just you have to let it play out. So I understand that. That's fine. Kawhi and Paul George are treated like superstars because they are superstars and they have that power. But that doesn't mean they should abuse that power. There's a reason why the phrase lead by example is so popular and almost cliche in sports, right? Because it matters. Lead by example. And so it's not up to Doc and the Clippers to get Kawhi and Paul George to be good teammates and go to practice and do these things, right? It's on Paul George and Kawhi. Look, Kawhi, they have the power. So they have the responsibility and they have to hold themselves accountable. Whether they want to do that or not, you're seeing it's not working. Apparently, look, and I don't even say record-wise, they're fine. You know, there's some ups and downs, but apparently, right, chemistry-wise, it's not working. It's not like Kawhi is this inclusive big personality that makes everybody feel welcome. That's an issue in itself. But now you're canceling walkthroughs, which essentially is like a light practice before games, right? And he's kind of flexing his power with no regard, and it's not hard to figure out who this is rubbing wrong, right? Because it ain't Magruder, it ain't Zubat, right? It's Lou Williams, Patrick Beverley, and Montrezl Harrell. The staples of the team from a year ago, the veterans who have been in this league and know how things kind of should look, as opposed to how maybe things are looking with the Clippers and how they're being treated, right? And so, you know, Lou is cool, right? Sweet Lou is cool. So he may just fall back and play it cool. But now Beverly and Trez, that's different, right? We all know their personalities and they're not going to bite their tongue, right? And they're not going to fall back. And so this is presenting some chemistry issues and you're seeing it play out on the court, right? You're seeing a lack of consistent effort and kind of chemistry, right? Now, it's obvious that the Clippers do lack true size. You look at their biggest rival in that same arena, and they have all this size. Montrezl Harrell, to me, seems like he may be the odd man out. Like before, I mean, I've done a couple trade videos here over the last few weeks, right? And you look at the Clippers, and you say, well, I don't really think they're going to be willing to break up that Lou Montrezl duo off the bench because it's so productive, right? And they have such good chemistry. And what can they really get out of it? I don't think they're willing to do that. But now that it's being reported and they've kind of let it out of the house that these dudes aren't feeling each other like that, maybe Montrezl is the odd man out, right? Could they move Montrezl Harrell to get that much needed size against a potential Lakers, Nuggets, Philadelphia, Milwaukee? You go through all the contenders. We've been over this. The Clippers lack size. That could be their Achilles heel. Now you combine the fact that chemistry isn't what they want it to be. I think Montrezl is the odd man out. Now let's be clear here. Montrezl, I don't think is going to be a Clipper next year, regardless, even if they win the championship. I think he's going to go explore free agency and someone's going to pick him up. So if they are to trade him right now, it's got to be to a team that really just wants his bird rights, meaning they are going to have the ability to re-sign him to a much bigger deal, the deal that he's been waiting for his entire life, right? He's been severely underpaid. So he's going to go get that money. And so that limits the trade options, right? But I came up with three trades, possible trades, to get the Clippers some more size and perhaps quiet the voice that is, you know, the guy that's being most boisterous about Paul and Kawhi, because the reality of it is you got to fall in line. They've kind of got to do it. Again, it's up to Paul and Kawhi to make the chemistry work. But if they don't want to do it and they want to be in their little clique, not hold themselves accountable, then that's what they're going to do. It may cost them in the end, but Montrez isn't going to have that power, so he might be out. So here we go. Three trades. The first one, Mo Harkless, Roddy Magruder, Montrez Harrell for Andre Drummond. Now, Drummond is the biggest name in free agency this offseason. So you're basically renting Drummond. You know, they probably won't resign Drummond anyway, but that obviously right away gives them the size they're missing. The rebounding presence, the size, not a great pick and roll partner for Lou, but you know, again, these, before y'all hop in the comments, you're like, these are ridiculous. Look, I know none of these are like ideal, but it's fun to play around. I'm not saying it works both ways. Now for Detroit, you're getting the rights again to Montrezl Harrell. That's the prize. And you say, well, why in the hell are they going to do that? But look, here's the sad thing about Blake Griffin's situation is he may be close to retiring. And look, I haven't read that anywhere, but just like, look at what's happened right now, right? How many knee surgeries can you have with his body and his frame? So what I'm getting at for Detroit is I think it's a complete teardown and rebuild. They got the kid. That draft pick looks good. Dumbayu? Right? Is it Siko Dumbayu? I'm butchering his name, but I've seen him. He just kind of is getting opportunity. So that's a nice little piece, right? But they're going to have to completely rebuild. So maybe Montrezl Harrell looks like he's from Detroit, right? I know he ain't, but he looked like a Detroit Piston. So that's why you do it. 'Cause you're going to probably lose Drummond anyway. I don't know. The reality is they probably could get a better deal for Drummond. I understand that. This is more kind of from the Clippers' perspective of trying to get Harrell out of that locker room and at the same time fix their size issues. Trade number two would be for Tristan Thompson. Harkless and Harrell for Thompson. Harkless, is it Harkless? Harkless? Why you got to be so heartless? All I know is he's nowhere to be found come playoff time. So he's in the deals because he's an $11 million salary. Tristan Thompson, again, you get the size. And he's kind of like Montrezl Harrell, right? They're similar players. I'd say Montrez probably a little more skilled offensively, but both pick and roll. He'd be a pick and roll partner for Lou. He's a better, bigger defender and a better rebounder. So I like that deal for the Clippers. And I think when you bring in a new guy into the locker room, regardless of their personality, they're the new guy. So they no longer can be disgruntled with Paul and Kawhi because it's Paul and Kawhi's team. The problem I think Harrell and I'm assuming Lou and Beverly are having is they're established Clippers. They felt like they've already built something a little bit. And so they feel like they have the power to speak up. Whoever you bring in, they're going to have to just fall back, right? And play a role. So I like that deal the best. This third one, I wanted to give you three. This third one, I don't know. But I was looking around. How about Jared Allen and Wilson Chandler for Harrell? And I know Nets fans are probably saying, man, we ain't giving up Jared Allen. We ain't giving up Jared Allen, right? I wouldn't. But according to Kyrie, he's not part of the master plan. DeAndre Jordan is. And Wilson Chandler, look, like he'll probably never even set foot on the court. He is familiar with Doc and the Clippers. So it could be maybe some insurance if he ever is able to be healthy. Jared Allen, I know he's slight, but he is a rim protector. He gives you some size and he can run the pick and roll with Lou Williams. And New Jersey, I love calling them New Jersey, boy. I don't know what it is, man. Brooklyn gets the rights to Harrell. I don't know exactly what their cap space looks like. Obviously, Brooklyn wouldn't do it as a rental move, but, you know, if they could retain Montrez to go along to give Kyrie's more pieces. They need more pieces, so that's kind of why I put Brooklyn in this deal, because just the way Kyrie was talking, but we all know Kyrie doesn't make the decisions there. But so those are three trades. Look, I know Clipper fans are going to hop in the comments and be like, man, this is fake news and blah, blah, blah. And they're going to try and downplay it as you should, right? But the proof is in the pudding. If you watch the Clipper games, you watch the body language, and Montrez is speaking out about it, right? So I don't, you know, look, maybe it can smooth things over. Now, the Clippers have quickly come out with reports like, oh, no, now they're watching video together and, you know, it's fine. It's nothing. Da, 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 da. Of course, that's what they're going to say. Of course. But it's something to monitor. And then you also look at, I want to point out, look at the standings, man. The Western Conference, look at what Utah's doing. Denver's no cakewalk. Like, the path through the Western Conference, you might want to climb up and get a top seed. Because if you're down there at 4-5 or something like that, Clippers, if you want to load management all the way through, it's going to be a very tough path even just to get to the conference finals. So I don't know. Let me know what y'all think. Do you have another trade to get Montrez out of there? I don't think you can move Beverly. They need him too much. Lou, I think, is, you know, I'm assuming it's those three. Again, I don't have that, but we do know that it's Montrez who has kind of spoken out to the press and send out the smoke signal. So I think he's the one that would probably be the odd man out. Anyway, as always, hit that like, share, and subscribe. I'm out, y'all. I've been winning so long, it's like alchemy.